This block operates under the same rules as the rest of the city. Mama is not the law. I am the law.
It's not often that a good comic book movie is made about an obscure character. So when it was announced in 2012 that a new film based on Judge Dredd was scheduled for a release, I skipped it. And I watched The Dark Knight Rises instead. But if I'd known then what I know now, I would have skipped the night, and instead, I would have watched.
Dredd.
Greetings, fanboys and fangirls, I'm E-Rod, and I'm the Blockbuster Buster. The Judge Dredd comic book series was created by John Wagner, Carlos Esquerra, and Pat Mills for the long-running British comic book magazine 2000 AD, in 1977, and it has been a major staple of the magazine throughout the majority of its illustrious run. When I was a kid, Judge Dredd was one of those elusive adult comics that I knew I wasn't supposed to be reading, but there would always be a kid who would sneak the comic book to school in his backpack, and we would spend gym class hiding under the bleachers, taking turns reading Judge Dredd. I grew up in a shitty neighborhood, so as a kid, I found the idea of a badass hero that patrolled a shitty neighborhood very appealing. Now, the idea of a Judge Dredd movie is nothing new. Believe it or not, a script was written and considered for development way back in the early 80s. But the original script was passed around and rewritten so many times that it became RoboCop. Now, I'm not dissing RoboCop. It's a great movie, but it ain't Dredd. In 1995, when I heard that a Judge Dredd movie was on the way, I knew that that movie was fucked from the beginning. For two reasons. Reason one, the film was being produced by Hollywood Pictures, which is owned by Disney. Yes, Disney was producing a film about one of the most hard-edged and violent characters in all of comics. Reason two, the trailers clearly showed that in the movie, Judge Dredd removes his helmet. For those of you who don't know, Judge Dredd never removes his helmet. Never! It's symbolic. Dredd is justice personified. He is uncorruptible, loyal, and faceless. Let's just say it took me a long time to forgive Sylvester Stallone for this movie, and I am yet to fully forgive Rob Schneider. For more reasons why this movie sucks monkey balls, I defer you to the Nostalgia Critic's review. It's one of his best. Anyway, it wasn't until 2012 that we got a proper Judge Dredd movie, written by Alex Garland and directed by Pete Travis. But before I get ahead of myself,
the secret origins of Judge Dredd.
In the not-so-distant future, the Earth is nearly decimated in a nuclear war. Most of the planet is a desolate wasteland, and what's left of humanity resides in the overcrowded megacities, where crime and corruption reign. So to maintain order and a semblance of peace, the justice system has been greatly abridged, in the form of the judges, who are fully deputized as police, judge, jury, and executioners. And they will carry out a sentence on the spot, and even execute a perp at the scene of a crime if they see fit. Secretly, experiments transpired to genetically create judges who were obedient, dedicated, and uncorruptible. Records will tell you that the experiment was a failure, but the truth is that one successful subject survived. Judge Joe Dredd. He is cold, collected, and his judgment is absolute. Dredd has no prejudice. He doesn't see gender or color or creed. In his eyes, there are only the innocent and the guilty. So don't cross him. Don't try to bargain with him. And most importantly, don't break the law, because he will find you, and you will be judged.
Incendiary. Negotiation's over.
The plot.
The chief judge gives Dredd a new assignment, to give rookie Judge Anderson her final evaluation. On their first day on patrol, the two investigate a triple homicide at the Peachtree Block. You see, in Mega City, each megastructure is basically its own town, and this block is ruled by the Mama Clan, headed by drug-dealing psychotic ex-hooker Madeline Madrigal, aka Mama. Through their investigation, Dredd and Anderson stumble into a much bigger plot, and Mama can't let them leave Peachtree alive, so she seals everyone inside the megastructure, believing that the judges will be easier to kill now that they are trapped with them. But the truth of the matter is that it is the Mama clan that is trapped with Dredd.
Oh! 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 Oh!
characters.
This movie does a great job of keeping things simple and giving you a taste of Judge Dredd's universe. Henceforth, only three main characters are introduced. First, we have our villain, Mama, played by the very lovely and talented Lena Headey. Originally, the script called for Mama to be played by an elderly woman. It was Lena Headey herself who convinced writer Alex Garland to change the character to a middle-aged, man-hating psychopath. Lena did a spectacular job of playing this undeniably frightening sadist who would mow down her own people to get what she wants. She is the queen of this block, and she doesn't care how many evil and despicable things she has to do to keep it that way. Then, we have Judge Anderson, played by Olivia Thirlby. Anderson is a mutant with mind-reading abilities.
Sir, he's thinking about making a move for your gun.
Yeah.
He just changed his mind.
Yep.
Which one would assume would give her an upper hand when solving crimes, right?
Sir, it's him.
Him who?
The man who murdered the people in the atrium.
You sure?
99%.
Can't execute a perp on 99%.
Also, it's kind of hard to carry out a death sentence when you can hear what your victim is thinking, or when some perverted jerkwad can distract you with his dirty thoughts. A big part of this film's enjoyment is watching Anderson evolve as a character, from a wide-eyed rookie to a badass judge. Being a judge is not a pleasant job. You have to do a lot of things that you may not agree with. Keep in mind, a judge has to make the decisions that it would normally take an entire justice system to make. And they make these decisions on their own, on the spot. Her relationship with Dredd is strictly professional. They're not buddies, they're not pals. He's just her supervising officer. The end.
If I don't come back and you get cornered, you might not want to get taken alive. Your call.
Sir.
She doesn't try to befriend or impress him. She does the best job that she can do in a nearly impossible situation.
Ready?
Yeah.
You look ready.
And last but not least, we have Judge Dredd, played by one of my all-time favorite actors, Carl Urban. This is another grand example of perfect casting. Like Kelsey Grammer as Beast, Josh Brolin as Jonah Hex, and Samuel L. Jackson as Nick Fury. I was excited about this movie way before I saw a trailer when I heard two things. One, that Carl Urban was playing Dredd, and two, a personal statement that Carl Urban made for the fans in which he reassured us that in the movie Dredd was never going to remove his helmet. This simple tiny little statement that let all of us know that the people making this film actually gave a shit meant a great deal to me. Carl is Dredd. He became the emotionally detached law enforcement officer that will execute a whole room of lawbreakers without thought or remorse. All of which is topped off with a mean scowl that will make the toughest tough guys pee their pants. Now, Judge Dredd was partially based on Clint Eastwood as Dirty Harry Callahan. Carl Urban admits that he partially based Dredd's voice on Clint Eastwood. Now, whether or not you can actually catch the similarities between the voices, you have to admit, this is the voice of Dredd.
This is Judge Dredd. I am the law.
See? That's how you say it, douchebags!
I am the law! The law! Law!
I am the law!
Favorite scene.
Major props to the post-production crew and the director of photography, because all the slow-mo sequences are mind-blowing. In the film, Mama is peddling a new designer drug called slow-mo, which causes the user to see things at 1% speed. This was a very cool, very unique motif that truly set the film apart. Another sequence that is simply awesome is when Anderson has to enter the mind of one of Mama's lieutenants, one that has been abusing and antagonizing Anderson throughout the first act. Seeing the rookie finally get one over on this scumbag is supremely satisfying.
I figured that would shut you up.
Hey, I can play mind games too.
Now, while this movie is jam-packed with one awesome action sequence after the other, my favorite scene is not really a scene, but a moment. As our heroes make their way through the megastructure, they are assaulted by a couple of kids with guns. Now, Mama didn't put a bounty on Dredd and Anderson's heads, so we can't help but assume that the kids are attacking the judges in order to impress Mama and hopefully gain entry into the Mama clan. Now, these two kids are pointing weapons at a couple of judges. The sentence for this is death. Dredd is supposed to execute them, but he doesn't. He stuns them, and he moves on. I consider this to be a microcosm of Dredd as a character. Yes, he is emotionally reserved and very violent, but only as a product of his environment. He is not a monster who would kill two misguided children for what more than likely is their first offense.
Freeze!
Why?
Favorite line.
Once again, it was a delight to hear someone say Judge Dredd's catchphrase properly.
I am the law.
And this movie does have quite a few great one-liners.
Choke on it, Dredd. Choke on that.
But my favorite line comes as a part of a discussion over the limits of Anderson's powers.
Take it this is your first time in Noxon combat.
Yes, sir.
I'm wondering when you'd remember you left your helmet behind.
Sir, a helmet can interfere with my psychic abilities.
I think a bullet might interfere with them more.
Final verdict.
Major props to the production design team, as Mega City doesn't look glamorous or romanticized. This place is a fucking hellhole that needs a bad motherfucker like Dredd to step in and keep the peace. Oh, and they did a magnificent job of recreating one of the coolest weapons in all of comics, the Lawgiver. Dredd's gun has a built-in computer that you can say aloud what kind of ammunition you want it to fire, and your wish is its command.
Hot shot.
Other built-in features include a display screen, warning when your ammo is running low, auto silencer, and my personal favorite feature, each lawgiver is keyed into its owner's palm print, meaning that only its appointed judge can use it. And you don't want to know what happens if someone that isn't a judge tries to fire it. Oh, and yes, my gun, the Caretaker, is a parody of both Hellboy Samaritan and the Lawgiver. I really, really want a sequel to this movie. This one already established that there are corrupt judges within the ranks. I really want to see that explored. I want to see Mean Machine and the pro-democracy terrorists. I want a big damn trilogy. And apparently, I'm not the only one, as 2000 AD Online has launched a petition to get a Dredd sequel made. So if you want to join the cause, feel free to visit their website and sign the petition, or visit their Facebook page and hit the like button. Carl Urban has expressed repeatedly that he is more than willing to put the helmet back on. So give us our Dredd sequel, now! I wish I would have gone to see this movie in the theaters, but to be perfectly honest, the trailers just didn't do it justice. I honestly thought that this was gonna be a movie that I was gonna end up busting. But as soon as it was released, I received hundreds of emails from you guys telling me that it was great, and that I should check it out as soon as I had the chance. So I did, and boy were you guys right. Cause this movie is a no-holds-barred tale of gore, violence, and hard justice that makes The Dark Knight Rises look like an episode of Yo Gabba Gabba. 10 points on the badassitude meter! Keep your lawgiver holstered and give it a watch. Justice is served.